Hi children, good morning everyone. So this is the class 4th, lesson 4, that is science. Sorry, this is lesson 5, that is food and digestion. Okay, food and digestion. Sorry children, this is lesson 5. Okay. So we have completed till what the nutrients do for us in the page number 171. Page number 171. Okay, vitamins helps to our body to fight with diseases. Mineral helps in the formation of bones, teeth, and blood. Calcium, potassium, iodine, sodium, iron are the examples of minerals. Okay, we get vitamins and minerals from fresh fruits, vegetables, meat, fish, liver, and milk. Food rich in vitamins and minerals keeps us fit and healthy. They are called protective foods. Now this is about the vitamins and minerals, that is what children, protective food, because they are protecting from us from the diseases, right? So protective food are what they are called as, what children, they are known as vitamins or minerals, or vitamins or minerals. Okay, vitamins and minerals. Okay, so as you know that vitamins and minerals are found in most of the food, okay, like iron, iodine, calcium, these are called as minerals. What are the vitamins? Vitamin A, vitamin B, yes, vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin E, yes, vitamin B6, vitamin B12, vitamin B complex, these are all the types of vitamins, and they are found in the different types of food. Okay, we must have food that contain vitamins and minerals through our body needs a very small quantity of them. Okay, yes, so what our body require only small amount of vitamins and minerals. They are also called as micronutrients. Okay, roughage is the fiber present in our food. It is necessary for the proper functioning of the digestive system. It adds bulk to the food. Water is essential for our body to function properly. 3/4 our body weight is water. So how much consists of our water children? That is 3/4. 3/4 means what children? 75% of our body is only water itself. Okay. So roughage is a fiber which helps in the digestion of our food. Okay, you can find roughage in the carrots and ginger, radish. These are all fibrous vegetables. Okay, and you know children, what is very essential? What? Why we are drinking water? So it can dehydrate ourselves and even it helps in the digestion. Okay, next one, a balanced diet. See, this is very important, children. Balanced diet. Balanced diet has right amounts of nutrients, that is carbohydrate, fats, proteins, vitamins, and minerals. So a diet which has all nutrients be in a right proportion or right amount, that is called as balanced diet. This is very important, children, because until and unless balanced diet is not proper, then our diet is not proper, then we can be suffer with disease, we can be sick. Okay, then is digestion of food. The food that we eat not directly used to provide energy. Here children, I am reading here. Okay, it is broken down into a simpler form. The process of breaking down of food into a simpler form is called as digestion. The digested food is absorbed by the blood and taken to all parts of the body. So after going into the after food is going to into the mouth, then it the mouth, the digestion process starts in the mouth itself. Okay, because the chewing process is also called as digestion. Okay, next, this digestion, the process of digestion is what you call as mixed with the blood, and then it is providing us energy. The process of digestion, now here children, the process of digestion, the process of digestion begins from the moment we put food into our mouth. With the help of our teeth, we bite, chew the food and break into small pieces. As we chew, the saliva in our mouth mixes with the food. The saliva is a digestive liquid secreted by the salivary glands. Saliva changes the insoluble starch in food into soluble sugar. That is why starchy food like bread and rice taste sweet after we chew them. So here they are saying about the process of digestion. Okay, after balanced diet, what is this, children? The process of digestion. Digestion begins from the mouth itself. Okay, so when we are chewing the bread or what we feel very taste. Okay, sweet in taste. Okay, and the saliva mix the food. The saliva mix the food and it goes into the mouth. Okay, because the saliva is the main part in the process of digestion. Okay. From the mouth, the food passes through the food pipe. See here, children, the salivary glands. Okay, the salivary glands produces what, children? Saliva. It helps into the digestion of food. Next, it is in the mouth. Okay, then the food is passes through the food pipe. Then it enters into the stomach. Okay. So food pipe into the stomach. The stomach is a hollow muscular bag. The food is churned here. Okay, the digestive system juices in the stomach break down the proteins, help in the food into a simpler form. From the stomach, the food is pushed into a long coiled tube called the small intestine. The inside walls of the small intestine produce the juice that mixes with the food. The liver and the pancreas also pour juices into the small intestine. These juices help completely digest the food. The digested food is almost like a liquid. Yes, the digested food is almost like a liquid. So here you can find out, children, here the food is entering into this pipe and then it is mixes with the stomach. Then the food is churned here. Then what happened? It is going into the small intestine. This is pancreas and this liver is also pour juices into this. Okay. And this juices completely digest the food. Okay. The blood vessels present in the walls of the small intestine absorb the digestive food it carry to the parts of the body. The undigested food passes into the large intestine. The blood vessels of the walls of the large intestine absorbs the extra water. The semi-solid waste is passed through the anus. So now what will happen to the digested food, children? In the small intestine, the absorbed digested food carry into the all parts of the body because they can provide us energy. Okay, and the undigested food, it goes into the small intestine and it excrete through the anus. Okay, some tips for proper digestion. Have your food at fixed hours. Chew your food well before swallowing. Yes. Eat lots of green vegetables and fruits. Do not overeat. Drink plenty of water. Okay, you have to drink plenty of water. Okay, next one is, this we will do in the textual exercises. Okay, preparing food. We eat raw as well as cooked food. Fruits and certain vegetables are eaten raw. We should wash them properly before eating as to free them dust and germs. So whenever we have to eat, we have to wash the fruits and vegetables, then only we can eat, because it's already consists of pesticides. Okay, sprayed insecticides and pesticides. So we have to remove the dust as well as the germs. Okay, some foods such as rice and potatoes are boiled, idlis are steamed, puris are fried, potatoes and brinjals and meat are sometimes roasted. Okay, cooking makes food soft, tasty and easily digestible. It also kills the germs in the food. Okay, so there are different types of cooking, children, like frying, roasting, boiling. Okay, these all we do with the help of vegetables and fruits and the meat, whatever we have to eat. Okay, the food. Okay, now you can see this is the balanced diet food. The variety of food is there. Cooking makes a food soft, tasty and easily digested. So why we have to cook the food? So that when we are eating so it will be soft, digestible. Digestible is important because we can't eat directly the vegetables, right? We have to cook the food and then only we have to eat. Okay, things to remember while cooking. Now what are the things that we have to remember while cooking? Do not throw away the water while pulses are soaked. Okay, it contains vitamins used for cooking. So whenever you are soaking the pulses, then you should not throw them, that water should not throw them out, because it also consists of vitamins. Okay, Do not wash vegetables and fruits after cutting them. Okay. While boiling, take just enough water so that water which has dissolved nutrient is not thrown away. Okay. So whenever you are boiling the vegetables, when you are doing the soup, yes, preparing the soup, then what you are doing, you are just drinking the soup itself, right? Because it consists of nutrients. Do not overcook. Too much roasting and frying destroyed the roasting. Okay. So when we are roasting the meat and we are using the oily items, like oily things, that also we have to keep in your mind. We should not do overcooking of food. Okay. Preserving food. In this page number 174, children, page number 174 here, preserving food. Food is valuable. If not preserved, it may begin to spoil. The process of treating food in a way that preserve its value for long time is called as preservation. Okay. Next one is preservation. So in the preservation, what will happen? The cooked food that is packaged, okay, so that it should not it should prevent from the spoilage. Okay, that we are doing with the preservation. Cooked and uncooked food can be preserved into two different ways. Okay, see here, you can see the diagram, children. What is this? This is refrigerator, means cooling, that is freezing of the food. Okay, next one, drying. Few of the things, spices are dried. Okay, this is pickling, means adding the salt, adding the oil, that is called as preservation of food by pickling. Okay, jellying. Okay, the concentrated sugar syrup is preserved in this type of food, jellying. Okay, next one is canning. You can find the food items in canned one. Okay, like Coca-Cola is there, that is also canned process. Few food items are you can find outside in a canned. Okay, and boiling. Yes, obviously boiling. By boiling of milk, it kills the germs, destroys the germs. Yes, so these are the, even when we are drinking water, what we got have the suggestion, like we have to drink only the boiled water itself. Okay, children. Words to know. Nutrient, substance in food which keeps us alive and healthy. The digestion, the process of breaking down into a simpler form. Okay, children. So this is our fifth lesson, children. Okay, I hope you have understand, and please try to read at home. Okay, so that you will get to know so many things, and I hope you have understand and you have learned a lot of things in this. Thank you, children. Take care. Bye.
Our topic for today is digestive system in humans. Digestion is a process in which complex food material is broken down into simpler substances. The digestion of food in humans takes place in the alimentary canal, which is a long tube extending from the mouth to the anus. The different parts of the alimentary canal are buccal cavity, food pipe or esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine and anus. Two glands, namely liver and pancreas, also help in digestion. The food is taken in through the mouth. It is chewed and mixed with saliva in the buccal cavity. Saliva is a digestive juice secreted by the salivary glands. The chewed food enters into the food pipe or esophagus and is then slowly pushed into a bag-like structure called stomach. The food is churned in the stomach to further break it down. The stomach also secretes mucus, digestive juices, and hydrochloric acid. The hydrochloric acid kills the bacteria in the food and makes the food acidic. The food then goes into a highly coiled tube called small intestine. The small intestine receives secretions from the liver and pancreas. The liver secretes bile juice, while the pancreas secretes pancreatic juice. The walls of the small intestine also secrete juices which help in further digestion of food. The inner surface of the small intestine has finger-like projections called villi. The villi have extensive network of blood vessels. The digested food is then passed into the blood vessels. The undigested food is passed into the large intestine. It is wider than the small intestine. Excess of water and salts are absorbed here, and undigested waste is passed out of the body through the anus.